It is always a mistake in politics to pursue two aims simultaneously, the more so if even the first aim is so ambitious that it can at best be attained by the utmost concentration of all strength and then only with a lot of luck. Everyone so far who had set himself the goal of dominating Europe had foundered, Charles V and Philip II as much as Louis XIV and Napoleon. This was not perhaps necessarily a reason for dismissing any new attempts as hopeless from the start. It was at least conceivable that Germany in the 20th century might succeed where Spain in the 16th and France in the 17th and 19th had failed, but it was a reason for not needlessly increasing the enormous predictable obstacles to the project by the addition of one that had nothing to do with the matter. Anyone wishing to conquer Europe ought not to have added to the number of enemies who would predictably arise in Europe by making scattered but influential enemies throughout the world and in his own country. That was a mistake, especially when those arbitrarily made additional enemies had previously been best friends, and that is what the Jews were until Hitler turned them into enemies. Okay, I'm pausing this recording. Okay, I've changed the preamplification to a plus 15 decibels. It makes little difference how high one assesses the influence of the Jews on the politics of their respective countries. Hitler probably overestimated it, which should have been one more reason for keeping them on his side and not needlessly pushing them into the enemy camp. Prior to Hitler, Jewish influence in the world had predominantly been a pro-German element, a fact which Germany's opponents in the First World War were only too well aware of. In America, it had long and effectively opposed the country's entry into the war on the side of the Entente. In Russia, it had played an important part in the revolution, successfully operated from Germany against the Tsarist Empire. By his anti-Semitism, Hitler not only needlessly created additional enemies throughout the world, he also made enemies of friends, and he transferred a weight which had previously been on the German side of the balance over to the other side, a double loss. Pause recording. Okay, so that previous one was a plus 15 add. I've lowered it to a plus 10 add. And this is a base boost as opposed to a base and high-end boost. The handicap which Hitler saddled himself with from the very outset by his anti-Semitism in Germany itself is also underestimated. Even though that anti-Semitism initially manifested itself only in continuous humiliation, defamation, and discrimination of the German Jews, and did not at once reveal its horrific final forms. Humiliation is quite sufficient to turn friends into enemies, and the German Jews, in their great majority, were positively in love with Germany right until Hitler. A small number, touchingly, still is, even after Hitler and in spite of Hitler. Okay, I'm going to end this recording here.